My father said to me one day, what would you like to be, son, when you grow up? And I said, I want to be free as a bird. My mother was the wardrobe mistress of the local theatrical company, and I started collecting swords, and I can remember a sequence of them, and they were 25p each swords in those days. And I would help my mother with various plays, and it would say in the programme, Swords by Nicholas Hall, but it wouldn't say this Nicholas Hall is 8 or 9 years old. I collected for a very long time, and I had nothing to do with the armed forces whatever, and then a friend persuaded me to join the Army Cadet Force, which I did, and I got promotion in the Army Cadet Force, and so I ran the two interests in tandem. My parents backed me in many ways because I helped with many local theatrical companies, but my parents were worried that I would get into trouble with the police, and also the state of my bedroom, because you hang the weapons on the wall with 6-inch nails, which isn't too good for the plaster.
How much is that?
That one's 40 quid, that's gorgeous. It costs the Admiralty £50 each, but that one is brand new.
Men nowadays are much, much bigger than men were during the Second World War. This is particularly true in your lower leg, because most of us drive now, and that's like working out all day on those lower leg muscles. And you just can't get them into Second World War clothes because they didn't drive in those days. They were too poor to drive in those days. So when they made the film, you're going to have distressed gear in the film, which is after the fighting, and mint gear that's just come out the quartermaster stores. So people went to France and they bought everything real in France they could, because that was left over from the war. But then they had to make hundreds of costumes like this one, which is a copy of the uniform worn on D-Day, which in fact was actually designed to be worn in North Africa, because the first time the American troops operated were in North Africa and in Sicily. But we were in summer. So by the time you get on to the bit of Band of Brothers about Bastogne, you're then wearing a different uniform. And again, those had to be made. And at the end of the film, they were trying to sell off the soiled ones, and nobody would buy them because they were so disgusting and so filthy, nobody wanted them.
Did he drive the fastest milk cart in the West, or was it a Vespa? He drove the fastest Vespa in the West. Oh, nothing worse than a Vespa in the West. Oh, that's the right case.
They cost the Admiralty £50 each. Plan for the stock at the moment? This is a very, very tortuous question, because my wife and my son would very much like me to wind down, because they're very nervous about, if I quit this mortal coil, what on earth are they going to do with it all? But I have a very well trained manager of the shop, Richard Ingram, who is an author in these matters, and he has assured me that if I quit this mortal coil, he will assist my lovely wife by helping her get rid of all this stuff.